Hey yo! It's December, and does that mean the projects end? No way! We got a big one coming up now, and it's gonna be a new fence for the border between my neighbor and I's property. We're gonna make a nice, really good improvement here with this cedar stockade. We got two gates for us. What we're gonna do is take down this old chain link fence of hers. We're gonna rip it out and we're gonna replace it. And we're gonna have a nice gate for her here, replace this, and we're gonna have a nice gate for us over there. And we're going to basically come up and then we're gonna take out all these bushes. That is actually the first thing that we must do, and that is today. And that will allow us to open up this nice back side yard because these bushes are encroaching and they're a pain in the butt to maintain because I'm a shorty and I'm really short. And even with a ladder, it's like a pain in the butt to maintain these over the summer. Shot I, ready, set, go. So, yeah. Yeah, we're gonna get rid of these bushes and it'll be nicer. And we'll have a nice, be able to have a nice garden back here. Super nice garden, lots of vegetables to be planted. So, first things first, let's get cutting and get rid of these. Oh yeah. So far, so good. Cut about half of them so far. My trailer's already full, so I'm gonna have to make multiple trips. Woo! All right, check it out. The bushes are all gone. I used a chainsaw and like a hack thing, electric battery one, to get all these bushes out. Now it's time to demo this chain link. Bye-bye chain link. So let's get to it.
Yeah. We'll have to chainsaw this up. And this is good because it's a little away from the house. But what, I forgot to ask you to bring a board so you can put it against the house. But we'll do that later.
Yeah.
But that's pretty good. If you want to hold... You're going to hold her level while I put the reed in. And we want to have it... Let's have this slightly off the wall here. Boom, like right there.
Okay. You've got a marker.
So, but we want to be a little off the wall too, because we're going to have to chainsaw this off.
Yeah.
So, I can go get marker. We're going to need a marker anyway.
That's me. Do you want to check that you're happy with it where it's positioned?
Yep, it's a little off the wall. So we can change. Yep, that's good. Probably move it over a little bit more actually. See?
Yeah. Good?
It just goes like. Good.
Where do you want to go from?
Let's go a little lower. Bring it to the edge of the 4x4. On the other side.
Other side?
Yeah, see, like, hook it on there. Yeah, we're going to go there. Fucking, like, squirrels making a fucking...
Is this your piece? The first piece?
This is the piece we need, yeah. Because this is the 4 foot high section for that little...
All right. Part.
You may need to watch your feet when you get over here. Actually, Dad.
What?
Let us shut it down one more sec.
You can.
Now, can we bring the bottom in? Halfway in between the two. There you
yeah.
go. That's good.
Good. Now, how do we know we're level? What do you mean?
Halfway in there?
Yeah, about that.
Here comes Santa Claus.
Give me a little.
Come Santa Claus right down Santa Claus Lane.
Just give me a little. Oh, fuck.
He doesn't care if you're rich or poor, he loves you just the same. Santa Claus knows we're all the children, that makes everything right. So fill your hearts with Christmas cheer, cause Santa Claus comes to ride. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus right down Santa Claus Lane. Come around the time, bring out that it's Christmas morn again. Peace on earth will come to us. Run, run, Rudolph, I'm reeling like a merry go.
Let's see if these nails work.
Dead Santa to a girl's town, what the please you want to get? A little baby doll that can cry to sleep, drink, and wet. You don't want to use screws. You ever have to remove it. A lot harder.
You want to check the level again?
There must be a fire or something going on. Good?
Good.
This here,
okay,
and it's like it's if you're it's just got to be as middle as possible,
okay.
So, just as long as she's level as much as possible now, and then it's in the middle of the hole, right?
Yeah,
and then it's like, and then we'll adjust it as necessary. As long as it's like right there,
I'm gonna go up a little bit, about an inch.
There you go.
Because it's like, comes to point too.
Yeah. The eye. Let me see.
So much.
That's right.
Just
want to.
less fine, but like...
Oh.
Then my side will join up there.
Just for a second. I'm landscaping today.
See if you can, see if you can, shave slightly to that side. And shave slightly to your side too. Just because we're going to load these up with concrete more than the other posts. In fact, I can probably shave it with this thing. Yeah. So how this works then?
Okay, so we are in the final stages of this fence project. Now we're at basically the gate. We're hanging the gates, the two gates that will go here. First things first, I'm gonna replace this little section here. Made a little mistake in the measuring. Got a little complicated kind of foot thing here, which I wanna plug up. This is like a little piece I stuck in there for like temporary purposes, but I got an extra piece. Cut this out next time the right way. So we're gonna put this back in. I already marked out the places where it's got to go, just so, and I already got it blocked up, so it'd be easier just to put in and hopefully just line up correctly. But the only thing is, it's a little of an angle, kind of goes up a little bit, as you can see, kind of slopes up. So I'm trying just to make sure it kind of goes as close as possible and to clear this as well. Is that a mosquito? Oh my god, that is a freaking mosquito. I can't believe it. It is December, almost January. And look at that. Hold on. Get an angle. That is a mosquito. They will never go away. So, there she is now. Little adjustment. I gotta screw this onto the bottom rail here, right there, so it's a little more stable. Let's knock this back. Unfortunately, there's like a handle to this old fire chimney thing over on this side, which is kind of in the way, which is kind of annoying, but it is what it is. So, but it's a lot better than having a little piece there just kind of randomly hanging out, and I'm just making little adjustments. So now it's on to the gates. Let's do a gate. So I realized I was getting tunnel vision and was just like, and not recording while I was doing this, but the hinges are on. They are on. Kind of a pain in the butt when you're doing this by yourself. Because it's helpful to have someone hold the gate for you. So, if you ever do this, have someone hold the gate for you. Because even though I had blocks here to hold the gate up, and I was using this like PVC pipe to basically lean it on, it would have gone a little faster, but nobody, no big deal. I like trying to figure it out by myself too. But hinging, now we're just putting on the latch. I just literally put on the bar. Now what you want to do is take this and line it up. Now the key thing to remember here is I had to install blocks here. Just notice that there's no blocks here that would be there otherwise. But I installed a block here, so when I put this on, it's going to, whoops, latch on onto the block rather than it would have latched onto nothing. Because, oops, hold on, let me get, because otherwise it would have latched onto nothing, as you can see, without that block being there. And it's the same thing on the hinges side. You want to make sure you put blocks in. Put blocks in right there so the hinges have something to bite onto when you drill them in. Fun facts. So, the latch is on. Woo! Awesome. Screwed in there. Now, here's the thing. I think I'm done, but I might have to adjust it one more time. Is the tension on these automatically closing latches. There's a little piece of metal thing in here. You push this Allen key in, you twist it, and you push the metal thing in the hole so it stops it, and that increases the tension. You gotta do it on both things. So, let's see how she does as I open it up the gate. Look, it's automatically closing. Will it shut? One might say that gate is well hung. Oops, got tunnel vision again. But she's done. In fact, they're both done. Both gates are hung. They are looking pretty good. I like how they open and close, automatic closing. Boom, like that. You can always tighten them if necessary. And there you go. As you can see, I have a lot of dirt to add to mine, but if I hung it low like that, that would have looked like crap, I think. And I need to add dirt anyway to here to get water to flow away a little bit more from the house. So it's all in the end working out. But there you go. There's one more fix I gotta do back there. Let's go do that now. So you got the end of the fence, right? And you don't have enough space for a full picket. So I thought at first, just to keep the dogs from escaping, is put just one down here. But I think I can do one better. So I'm gonna do a full picket, but just cut it in half. Now this is 2 inches up here, but it's 1¾ inches here. So this is like 22½ inches high, and I'll just have to make sure that it's 1¾ inches. That means there'll be a little bit of a gap, but nothing crazy. I think it's gonna be a lot better.
Let's do it.
Boom. 2 screws in. All right. So it's been about 1 or 2 months now. And let's take one last final look. Fence here goes across, goes down like this. Let's walk down here. Now I want to show you the addition of the dirt that I needed to do to raise up this area, because you remember there was a bunch of, like, there was a hole here. So over here is about like 1½ yards, and you kind of see the dirt right here, you know, dirt. And then I use it to pitch away from the house, and also bring it up to level with the bottom of the gate. So there you have it. Here is what it looks like it's done. Huge improvement, tons more space. And now the next step is to stain her, but we're now gonna wait till it warms up a bit. So couple things I would say you probably want to make sure you do if you're going to put wooden fence like this in. It's going to need this is about 1, 2, I think it was like something like 9 posts, 9, 10 posts. I think I used about like 12 bags of 80 pound concrete, and that's what it took. And I used a lot more on the, and filled the holes all the way up with concrete on the posts, on the hinges in particular. Yep. And there you go. Hope this was informative. If you have any questions, comment it below and I'll answer them. And I hope it's inspiring for you to improve your backyard, as I'm excited to continue to improve ours. Peace!